Episode 26, we're talking TVs. Is there anything better? I don't think you've got your 3D glasses on, right?
There's nothing better. I have my ghetto 3D glasses on. There's nothing better than TVs. Let's just talk about
it. Let's talk about it. All right. Every man has a thing for televisions. We do.
I don't know. And the bigger, the badder, the brighter, the, you know, just want to, you know, I don't know what it is. You know, it might be just something that's in our nature that men just want this really big TV. Yes. You know, not too long ago, my wife and I, we purchased a Sharp 60 inch. It's an LCD.
Right.
It's absolutely beautiful. The picture quality is ridiculous. It's phenomenal. We really, really enjoy it. But, you know, one of the things that I was curious of, I was like, what is trending for 2012 for TVs? You know, we're hearing a lot about smart TVs, right. All the smart stuff. You know, my TV has, you know, like at least like, I don't know, like 20 apps on there. You know, I have Pandora, Twitter, Facebook, Netflix, which we love. We love Netflix.
Love.
And the list goes on and on and on. So, you know, but what else, you know, do we think will we see in TVs for this year, Zev? What do you think?
So we saw at CES 2012 that three main things were trending. Of course, many things have trended over the years, and we could talk more about the underlying technology behind it. But three of the main ones are LED,
right.
OLED, and these kind of conversion kits that are going to be these smart TV conversion kits. So the first one, of course, LED. LED is a light emitting diode. It's a very small transistor, basically. It doesn't have a filament, and it doesn't get hot. It doesn't burn out as quickly, and it's very efficient as far as energy goes. So right. You'll see a lot of televisions, LED televisions, LCD televisions, liquid crystal displays, that have gone from CFLs, which means that there are basically those compact fluorescent light bulbs, which had really thick televisions, and they've gone to very, very thin.
Yeah.
So that's a main one, going over, becoming very thin, very power efficient, and being able to go very large.
So, I mean, we're talking about like the LG TV that was being displayed down at CES. You're talking about 5 millimeters thick.
Yeah,
I don't even know what that means, 5 millimeters. I mean,
yeah, so
Mamma mia.
Yeah, when you go into that next level, which is that OLED, and the OLED is basically an organic
light emitting diode.
Yeah, light emitting diode, but it's an organic molecules on films, and the films, because when you introduce electricity to the films, you don't need a backlight. So it's very thin. I mean, we're talking uber thin. So they're saying in 2012, 55 inches from Samsung and some others.
Right. So what we're talking about then is less technology to display that picture, so the screen can be made thinner and thinner and thinner.
And gorgeous black levels and just,
oh yeah, I know.
I mean, gorgeous, gorgeous color.
Absolutely, but they're still pretty pricey though.
Very
I think the Samsung or the LG, I forget which one, is about $5,000. So
yeah,
it's up there, you know. I mean, the 60-inch that my wife and I just purchased, we got the sale for about $15.
And that's probably LCD.
That is an LED LCD, yep. Correct. Yeah. And you know, so, and that's the only reason why we bought it, you know, because it was $1,500. It was 60 inch. It was a Cyber Monday sale. We say, you know, what the heck, you know, let's just go buy it. Otherwise, if we waited for just any other day, any other Monday, for example, it would have run us like 2,000 and change.
Right.
So we're like, you know what, this is a good deal. Let's just do this thing. And make it happen. So, you know, at a CES, we also heard the Super HD TV display.
Yeah.
These 4K displays.
Right. So we know HD TV is either 1280 by 720 resolution or 1920 by 1080. And that's why we get the 1080 in that number, the 1080i, 1080p. The Super HD TV, otherwise known as the 4K or the 8K, is 3,840 by 2,160, or the 8K is 7,680 by 4,320. We're talking orders of magnitudes clearer,
yeah,
right?
Know, right? Yeah, yeah.
It's getting a little insane. And a lot of the movie theaters now have 4K projectors for their high definition stuff. So you're going to be seeing more and more movie shot in 4K. And as a result, as those projectors start to become more readily available, because they're incredibly expensive. So, yeah, we'll see it. But the shining light on the horizon is that the cameras like Red and others that are making that cost come way down to the $20,000-$30,000 level for base models. That makes movie production very easy, and you're going to see 4K and 8K models. Yeah. Plus, if you really think about it, other than the power savings for these TV manufacturers, they want to sell more TVs. So how are you going to sell more TVs? Make content that they can't get on those low-end 1080p models. So
those crappy models. and the other things that came out of CES as well, right? So it's about gesture controls. What does that mean?
Yeah.
So think of having an Xbox Kinect, I'm sorry, not Xbox, but a Kinect in your TV. So as you can literally walk up to your TV and say, TV, play Netflix, TV, go to channel 7, and then you can do your swiping gestures up and down and sideways, whatever the case might be.
Plus facial recognition.
And facial recognition, right? So, for example, and I'm thinking about parental controls here, right? So if your child walks up and says, hey, I want to watch channel, 47, and channel 47 is the porn channel, then guess what? It scans your son's face or your daughter's face and says, sorry, kids. No porn for you, or it's after your bedtime. Sorry, kids. No more TV for you. It's after your bedtime, which is pretty impressive. We're also talking about more apps. To your television, and also cloud-based content coming to your television. So similar to like what Netflix does, right? A lot of streaming content coming now to your TV. So
And this is based on, from what I understand, this is based on Google TV's next generation of smart TV. So you've got Samsung that gave the presentation and talked about their smart televisions, and that looks phenomenal, as you said, with all those different features. And then of course having a conversion kit, which is that third category, which means that the screen, which is very expensive, you're going to spend money on a 4K screen, let's say, you're going to be dropping a lot of cash. So you want to know that you're going to be able to keep that screen for a long period of time. They'll actually enable it to have components that can be swapped out from like a base unit, and then you can always upgrade. So it keeps it that longevity of the product.
And it's not that expensive for us, right? It's about less than $500.
Right.
So that's not breaking the bank, so to speak. Especially if you are a videophile.
Right.
If picture quality is your thing and you don't have the cash to drop, $5,000 or more, then maybe getting one of these conversion kits for $500 might not be a bad move.
True.
So it sounds like there's a lot of hardware coming out. ITV.
You're right.
It's supposed to be coming out sometime this year. That is the rumor.
Yep.
And they're supposed to be, disrupting the entire TV space or industry. And Apple has a habit of doing that. Has a habit of walking in and throwing a wrench in the monkey works.
Yeah, I'm interested to see what they're going to be bringing to the market, because it really, what seems to be this year's major trend, not only is just the displays, that's the main category, I think. The display quality is a really big thing, especially with last year. Samsung was really taking it with the Super AMOLED technology on the mobile devices. So I think screen technology is going to be huge this year. And I think the second part of it is that smart television access, having the apps, having the tie-in of all those social media services, having the interaction voice-wise and gesture-wise. I think that's going to be the major trend. So everybody's going to try to take a piece of that. We'll see who leads it out.
And again, we cannot forget content. I mean, these TVs, as beautiful and as expensive and as wonderful that the technology they shove into this box, into this square, is, it all pretty much sucks if you have crappy content being pushed to that TV.
And no one likes crappy content.
No. Everybody likes that, Seriously, honestly, no one likes crappy content. All right, guys. So I think that's it. Those what Zev and I think will be happening this year. And hopefully we'll see maybe half of that, 20% of that come true.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Tell us what you think. Put down in the comments. Tell us right what there. You think are the next upcoming things in 2012 and what you expect to see from these manufacturers.
Give us some commenting love.
As always, thanks for watching. Only cool people press subscribe. Right here. That thing right there.
So tonight I've got the Dora, the Spanish gluten-free loveliness.
I got nothing.
No, you're not even ghettoing sangria tonight. I got nothing.
I have beer upstairs, dude.
I'm so tired.
My son's in the next room, and the minute he sees me, he's going to want to run in here. He's going to play with the laptop, with the PC. He's going to want to talk and... He's 3 years old. You can't tell a three-year-old no because you throw a temper tantrum. It's like, oh, God.
It's true. So. It's like a 60-year-old woman.
Yeah, you know.